Pregnancy can be an exciting time in a person's life, but it can also cause anxiety. Common concerns that my patients have are whether their job could cause them to have a miscarriage. Turns out that some jobs can make miscarriage more likely. Stay tuned and I will explain. Regardless of what your job is, if you have to work at night, the so-called night shift, you may be at greater risk for miscarriage. A 2019 study from Denmark showed this very clearly. In this study, they looked at over 22,000 pregnant women, determined their work schedules, and whether they had a miscarriage. Pregnant people who had two or more night shifts the previous week had a 32% increased risk of miscarriage compared with pregnant people who did not work night shifts. In fact, the more night shifts a person worked during pregnancy, the higher their risk for having a miscarriage. Jobs that require you to be on your feet for prolonged periods of time, like waitresses or nurses, might increase the risk for some pregnancy complications, like preterm delivery. But I could find no evidence that it increases their risk for having miscarriage. Waitresses, however, may be at risk from something else: cigarette smoke. Many restaurants no longer allow smoking, but a waitress that works in a bar or a club may inhale a considerable amount of secondhand smoke. An analysis of a number of studies of secondhand smoke exposure during pregnancy found that on average, the risk for miscarriage was increased by about 11%. Cigarettes aren't the only source for smoke. This study of firefighters found that compared to nurses, they had a higher risk for miscarriage. Flying in an airplane increases the amount of radiation you are exposed to. The more hours you are in the air, the greater your exposure. This could affect pregnant airline pilots and flight attendants. In addition, flying through different time zones can disrupt sleep patterns, and flight attendants also have to do a lot of physically demanding stuff. This study found that there was a modest increase in the risk of miscarriage due to radiation exposure, but a much more important risk when flight attendants experience sleep disruption or excessive physical demands. A few studies have looked at cosmetologists, specifically hairdressers and nail technicians. Hair dyes, depending on the type, can contain thousands of different chemicals. A few studies have found an increased risk for miscarriage in hairdressers. One study found a relationship between the number of chemical treatments given and the rate of miscarriage. A study from earlier this year found that female surgeons reported double the amount of miscarriages of other similarly aged women. Surgeons have a number of miscarriage risk factors, like erratic sleep schedules, long hours, and exposure to anesthesia gases that could explain their seemingly higher risk. What about having a stressful job? These kinds of studies are very difficult to do because it is very hard to measure stress. Studies looking at night shift work or hours of sleep are very objective, but stress is very subjective. There is no universally accepted measure of stress. That being said, some studies have found a mild increase in miscarriage risk based on job stress. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: some occupations do have a higher risk for miscarriage compared to others. The reasons vary from one job to the next. If you can avoid these jobs, there may be some benefit. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.